Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today, oh boy, only one replay. Skill, you gold noob! So, listen, there is a short story for you. Speaking about the IS-7 itself, right? About this vehicle. We got up to third mark of excellence level on RU server recently. We was using pretty much only P ammunition. Well, we had 10 gold if we need that, but we was trying not to use it and so on, so on. You will see a couple of replays with that loadout quite soon, probably this or next week, doesn't matter. But when I reached the 95%, after that, I couldn't move. I needed to go with a full gold, full consumables, and funny thing, those 5%, they took me over 100 battles. I think I finished with 210 battles in order to get up to 100%. It was insanely hard. In this battle, this game was won pretty much after this battle. I played one more game and then I got Mark of Excellence up to 100%, but oh boys, this battle. This is the game for which I am playing World of Tanks. This is the game which is raising your heartbeat. This is the game when you cannot read the chat, when you need to focus on the game and so on. Let's go. My neighbors is having a fest, don't mind me if you are hearing the music. Anyways, what is happening right here? IS-7, tier 10, matchmaking only one Arta. What I'm thinking, skill thing. Going to the city, 279, buds. Yeah, so what we are doing? On the field, that's what we are going to do in this battle. But skill is bad. You will see how bad it is. I am not thinking about playing passively. I'm not thinking about stopping by here. I am going on the full Ruski charge, full Ruski power, and we are going to show what IS-7 is all about. For some people, by the way, is IS-7 still competitive? Yes, it's still amazing tank, incredible tank, quite easy tank to play with, and in general, just beautiful vehicle. Anyways, it's not about that. This battle is only about the gameplay. Yes, we are starting slow, you know, while moving into position, so one Kranwagen is getting spotted in the middle of the field, but I simply don't care because I have my plan already. I have my plan, fellas. So what we are thinking how to approach the enemies in this kind of situation. We have a BR sniper schnitzel, 430U, another 430U and TVP. And look at the route which I am picking. I am not shitting my pants by any means. I am going. I'm spotted. Skill, you are spotted! I'm playing with IS-7. I don't give a flying F. So what we are doing right here, fellow tankers, we are going. We are going in front and we are showing from what kind of steel we are made. The Kranwagen disappeared like this because TVP clipped him. MX-13, 105, Grille. MX is still trying to clip us. We don't care. Russia! We are hitting the Grille in the face on the full move and Grille is disappearing. I am providing our team with spots right here and the Grille is just melting. Look at him. Grille melted. TVP is pretty much down to the one shot and he is dead already. First minute of the battle. Okay, second minute of the battle. Solid 3,500 right here. Clap, clap, clap. Just like this. You think we are done? No. You think we are winning this battle? Yes! Very easy! Easy peasy, just like this. Look, what will happen right here. So what we are doing, we are making a hardcore pressure for the enemy straight. We are just going in front straight like this. We try to yell Russia, but you know, probably my voice did not reach the gun. That's why we did not manage to hit him, but it doesn't matter. 140 down to the one shot. E4 is in the side. Our city is melting because 279 and 277 is just trying to clear the city right here. This is no bueno. I'm thinking, do I want to make an aggressive pressure or not? And I really want to make an aggressive pressure because I just need to do that. 140 meanwhile is punishing me for my stupidity because I showed the side of the turret and he got my ammo rack, but it's not a big deal whatsoever. So far, so good, fellas. E4 right here, I'm trying to find the shot into the E4. Pretty much pixel shot, not a big big problem. It's Russian tank. What did you expect it? And as you can see, the 268 is just going for us. I'm trying to wiggle, but hashtag never lucky. Can we finish that E4? No, we can't. 268 punished me quite a bit for my stupidity. 1000 damage dealt, 4000 assisting damage already. And oh boys, oh boys, we are just starting this battle, okay? We are just starting this game. What I am currently waiting for, I'm waiting till this object either shoot me or shoot someone else. And as you can see, he's not looking at me. That basically means we can go in and we can deal with this guy just like this. Art is getting slaughtered by our guys, which is in the back, which is very, very, very good. So, look. Currently, enemy forces is right there, but even though enemy forces are kind of crossfire, it doesn't mean they are losing this battle by any means. I'm trying to get a shot in the 907, but looks like the things is not going that well. Object is moving on the full speed. Not a problem, comrade. That's why I would pick IS-7 any day of the time instead of playing with a 705A. You don't believe in me? Well, check this thing out then. IS-7 is love, IS-7 is life. What I'm thinking now, you see this 279? This 279 is making quite some pressure for us, fellow tankers. And our 430U is yelling and trying to cap the base. So what do we want to do? We want to focus on this 279 for obvious reasons right here. It's better to fight with a powerful tank, you know, not one-on-one. What do you think? What kind of game this is? This is a team play. Our guy is banging his butt and we are just going, I don't even know how we managed to penetrate him right here, but this is a penetration. So far, fellas, so good. 3,400 damage, 4,400 assisting damage. And you think this is the most intensive part? No, no, we are just starting, fellas. I saw the Ruski light, which is going to decap the base on the 430U, and I want him to decap the base. As wrong as it sounds, I want our guy, the Ruski light, to decap the base. So what we are doing, we are piri, getting a bit closer. 430U just shot one LT-100 in the face, and last second, fellas, the capture goes to Ruski light. And now we are sitting in disgusting situation, fellas. I'm trying to hit this guy, but Ay, that was not the best aim, to be honest, so I have no rights to complain. Anyways, look into what kind of position we are sitting right here. Object 705A, 430, 907, two light tanks. We are in the crossfire right there, okay? Yes, I have 1000 hit points. Yes, he have 1,700 hit points. But look at this. When I said the crossfire, I truly mean it. The 907 is going quite aggressively. What do we want to do? We want to hit him. I had high explosive loaded for a light tank. And our 430U took a bit for the team from this 907 and 430U. 430U have the full hit points, fellow tankers. This light is trying to make a crossfire on me, and he's doing quite good job right here. We are hitting the 907, and 907 is down to the one shot currently. I'm trying to make an interesting angle so guys won't be able, the enemies won't be able to shit on me. The 705 pushing in front, P705 is going down. Now we are trying to make some kind of reverse side scrap against the 907, but it was not necessary because he died for our 430U. Meanwhile, the Ruski light is effing me in the back, and the French light is going down just like this. Woo! Oh, this battle, fellas. 430U did not manage to penetrate our muscle, okay? We are feeling super duper hyper turbo good. I'm thinking, does he have the high explosive loaded? Yes or no? Because I'm afraid. I tried to snap the shot, but hashtag never lucky. It did not, I did not hit where I was aiming to, which is unfortunate, but what can you do? What can you do? Nothing. So, what is our options right there? We need to F off from the crossfire. 430U is already making a bit of pressure for the 430 for enemy 430U, and Ruski Light is a good player, okay? He have already four kills, he captured the base in time, and what he did right there, it was just a solid banana out of 10, right? So 430U is waiting for me. I am not going to push on him straightforward, because 430U, our 430U have more hit points, and our 430U managed to hit him once. Now we are going for him, and he is dying for our 430U. And what a game that was. Now, fellas, fellow tankers, it's looking easy victory, right? It's looking easy victory. Is it? Is it looking easy victory? 28 hit points. 28 hit points, fellow tankers. That sucks. So, let's stop right here. If I would be a light tank, what I would do? I am trying to get into his brain. If I would be a light tank, I would go and kill Arta. I mean it. I would go and kill Arta right there. So, I would go like this to kill a clicker, or just go through the field like this, whatever, right? So, what is my guess? And what I'm doing, I'm going like this, and I think I'm going to meet the light. This is my prediction. We are putting the replay speed twice faster, so we can do this, let's say like that. I am saving your time, fellow tankers. The result is going to be the same. Nothing will change right here. So, as you can see, I'm going piri 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 just like this. I'm trying to wiggle through the houses, and I'm trying to figure out where the light is. But what our Arta is doing, our Arta is going and thinking about capping the base, okay? It's very interesting decision by our Arta, okay? It's very interesting decision. Our Arta is going closer to the cap circle. He is about to enter into the cap, and this is it. Now, fellas, what would you do in this kind of situation? What would you do? This is the question. What would you do? You are left alone against the light tank who knows what he is doing. By the way, this thing is indicating he got like into the League 1 or had the best rank in the ranked battle. So that's already saying quite a bit about the tank. And you know what? I'm not going to attack right here, because you can, in the Himmelsdorf, you could do that. The map is like wide, okay? Where there is a fields everywhere. With a heavy tank, which you are down to the one shot, you won't win against the light tank, which knows what he is doing. So what is our plan right there, fellow tankers? Our plan right there is to take the best position possible. What is the best position? Best position is over there, okay? This is the best position. So we will wait until he will go into the cap. Because I guess this guy is predicting and trying to guess. I will go like this. I will charge in front for that guy like this. That's what probably he is thinking, right? So in this kind of situation, we are playing cat and mice game, okay? This is cat and mouse game. So we are sitting in the bushes right here. There is 3 minutes left. Skill, you are playing for a draw. Nah, I'm trying to outplay this guy. That's what we are doing right here. And you know what is happening, fellas? We are sitting in the bushes. We are in our favorite environment with a tier 10 heavy tank. I mean, what could be better than wanking in the bush? Let's get real. And we are simply waiting. We are enjoying ourselves, and we are waiting. And you know what is happening, fellas? Look at this pretty score. This is, fellas, this is the game for what I love World of Tanks. It was intense, it was insanely enjoyable, it was hard, it was equal. The battle was equal right there. It was just solid banana out of 10. And that's why I love this game. Not for 15-1, not for 2-15, not for a new Steel Hunter mode. I don't give a flying F about this thing. I don't really think World of Tanks players needs that or really wants that. The World of Tanks players, in my opinion, needs that adrenaline pump when the battles are equal and when you need to think what kind of decision to make in order to win the battle. If it's not the case, then I can tell you that that's what I need to have the full pleasant gaming experience and enjoy myself. Anyways, fellas, in this battle, we raised like 1% of the mark of excellence from 98 to 99 or something like this. I can't remember that, to be honest, but that was an amazing game. Fellas, if you enjoyed this one, feel free to leave the thumbs up for me, for my motivation, and for my pretty face. For I repeat, fellas, for my pretty face. Thank you so much for that, and see you next time. But also, I hope you enjoyed this battle as much as I did, because I had a blast. Thank you, see you next time. Skill is out. Peace.